Romania to get us underway then in his third women's singles.
Make no, fast one. Make no mistake, this would be a big win as well. I mean, as you say, Minnie Sue, the lowest ranked of the three, 36 in the world, but she's only 20 years of age, and everyone knows about her quality. She's been top 25 in the ITTF rankings back in February, just slipped below that at the moment, but she's got really good momentum going through the group stage into the round of 16 as well, because the Hong Kong team, we talk about it being a younger team, but it is just basically trio. They play all the time. This is tough for Montero Dedin, and especially where the match situation is right now.
Yeah, exactly, because you'd imagine, Guy, that that would sort of free off Minnie Sue and just allow her to just be a little bit more sort of expansive in the way that she plays. The fact that she's bolstered by a two-love lead now.
Yeah, it's only once, really, Montero Dedin's come in the event behind like this. That was that... funny old loss, wasn't it, to the Netherlands, where she was, where she was actually the Romanian top player.
Yeah,
because of course the top two were it's the coin toss, the issue that
the late business with the coach.
Yeah, Villarreal Philemon wasn't able to be there for the toss. So then in that situation, you're not allowed to nominate your players into position. It has to just be done off alphabet, and that doesn't help the Romanians when you've got two players with surnames beginning with S. So that's the issue. They didn't get a look in, and the likes of Irina Chobanu and Adina Diakchonu were the ones who came in. So, yeah, but otherwise, this is difficult for Montero Dedin.
But that, all of that said, it's been a good start from her here. 3-point advantage already. Oh, that's fabulous. What a flip kill over the table there. Like a rocket.
Yeah, seized on a very short serve from Minnie Sue. Saw it very early, just flicked it away, she's saying.
An edge there, and a hand of apology is offered, almost not to rile her opponent. Super play, early cross-table backhand finish from Minnie Sue from the top draw. It was an aggressive rally. What tempo.
Oh, she's so good there, isn't she? Just getting on top of the ball and allowing it to move through the air, getting the right on top of the contact point. Doing that nicely in this opening game, isn't she? She's behind, still by two, but...
a little perplexed there, so good acceleration from the Romanian player. Wonderful redirecting off the backhand wing, and that spike down the table, long line there to finish, was immaculate.
Yeah, it's that change of direction again, and going back that way, which wasn't expected. It's actually a very, very tough shot to hit. Mm-hmm. Much easier to go with the spin, go back cross table, but went against it, worked out well.
Nine,
really good fight back this, isn't it, from Mini Sue? Been behind pretty much the whole game.
Lovely loop.
It's a long way back from the table there to be trying that particular shot.
Yeah, it's quite ambitious, isn't it?
In this game, I think, for Mini Sue at one stage.
Yes, she did, absolutely. I was just about to say, almost a terrific turnaround, but couldn't quite put the lid on it with a spirited ripping from the Romanian. Now, what sort of serve can she conjure up here? And down the line, spilling over the table, and the Hong Kong team up off the bench. So it's a game point opportunity then for Mini Sue here.
Yeah, second one, isn't it?
Takes the second game point opportunity and secures the game. 12 points to 10. Back for game two then, and it's all Hong Kong in the overall match and this game. They managed to seize the opener here in this third singles as well, so it's on paper all going in the pink shirt's favour. Now, Guy, that was a crushing loss of that opening game, wasn't it, to Montiello Dor down there?
Yeah, I think it's by five at one stage. She was always ahead pretty much till nine each in the game. It's kind of summarised the way it's gone for the Romanians here. It's another game, really, they'll feel that they should have won. You know, this could end in three matches. I mean, it's still a little way from... and you'll kind of wonder how.
Yeah, absolutely.
As you'd expect, they're use the phrase licking their wounds. Yes. There are plenty of them at this stage. I think if they do go on to lose the second match, the defeat for Soch is the big one. It's so easy to turn, clearly. Even if you reflect back on the one you did first of all, Samara's loss in four, fair outcome.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, yeah, I mean, she was training 3-1 head to head as well, so, you know, coming in there, and Li Ho Ching played very, very well, so it was pretty fair, to be honest. Oh, so close. Really impressed by Mini Sue. She's kept on the front foot and been, you know, good mental skills as well, went under a lot of pressure there in the opening game and turning it around. So you kind of sense that the scoreline now is reflecting the fact that she's a little bit more relaxed, having got that opener.
Clearly better to be coming in, playing the match as well, two up, as opposed to Montero de Dean here.
Oh, that's lovely. Huh? Seen too many of those wayward forehands from
Mini Sue.
And that one just got missed by quite a bit.
Yeah, lobbed up. I say it goes down as a bit of surprising miss. Again, so strong. The Hong Kong players have been so strong out of their backhand corner, going back to yesterday, the win over Chinese Taipei. Again here, just not giving a lot away. They're not giving a lot of table away when they're in the rally. Very strong in that regard. Of course, as we say that.
I was just thinking
he's actually slightly away from the table there. I think it's more when they're in the drill, when they're on top of the table. They're rarely missing that shot. Yeah. A little bit tougher when you're a little bit further away from the table, meaning to do a bit more with it.
Generally, they're normal service regimes. And as you said, that's the sort of standout quality that they all have.
And you can almost imagine them going backhand to backhand, can't you, endlessly without missing at a high tempo in practice, day in,
it's
day
like
out.
It just takes out earlier live. And earlier as well.
Exactly.
Net there on the way through, that's why she's apologising. Mini Sue.
2016 World Junior Circuit winner. As you said, takes some doing. Yep. Ranked second in the world under 21 rankings.
Yeah, it's what we've been saying a few times, isn't it, on commentary, that these players, they don't come out of nowhere. I mean, the ITTF Junior Circuit is very, very well-formed and successful, producing players who come through. So many come through into the main, the seniors, as they call it.
Certainly serve their apprenticeships, these players, don't they? As you say, they don't just stroll off the bus and have a go. It's a long, old road. But it's like any sport, you've got to do your 10 years or 10,000 hours to even really qualify to, you know, get on this kind of level, this stature that these guys are playing at. It's quite outstanding. And it's a really tactically intricate game, isn't it? All with the different rubbers as well and what have you. It's remarkable, really. These guys spent hours at the table just perfecting little nuances and set plays and different serves. So 11-4 then, Mini Sue get a toehold in this game. The younger opponent really has been quite dictatorial. And it's tough to see an in, isn't it? Because as soon as the Romanian steps away from the table, any little bit of that, then she's sort of, you know, it's tough to get any inroads.
Yeah, I think it's a good point you make, actually. Just an area of difference from the two in these first couple of games has been that. Just feel when Gudin... She's up to a metre, maybe more away from the table. She's in more trouble. Sue is capable of staying in the rally longer from there. She's been stronger. They've both been very, very good when they've been on top of the table. So it's been an area of difference. 2-1.
Sense how hard Montero Godin is, you know, trying. She's trying her heart out here, but it just can't dent the solidity in defence as well as attack of Mini Sue on a regular basis. There was another fine example. That time she had enough zing on the ball to kind of dent the armour, but it's a tough ask. And it almost means that she's having to redline, and hence there's a few too many errors. That's the issue.
Yes, absolutely. There's some frustration here as well, I think, now creeping through. The Romanian team, very competitive. I think we saw this as a big opportunity. Yes, we set this up as a very, very tight quarter-final on paper, but they would have fancied their chances. against this Hong Kong team, and it just isn't happening for all their efforts.
Her way through.
Sue is so loose now, as you'd expect at two up. Samara as well.
Three, five.
So can the 30-year-old sort of engineer some sort of platform to work from? Can she get a toehold in here and just get stuck in? If she could win a game, it would give her a lifeline and perhaps a little more belief, but she's up against this young player who is very convincing so far. Whoa, that's called the strawberry, isn't it? That was amazing. Don't get too many of them to the pound. Let's see it again.
Yeah, have some cream with that strawberry, yeah, I think.
Exactly. Very satisfying.
Idea why it's called the strawberry.
Well, the banana, yeah, I asked Adam this question.
The banana is
coming around the outside of the ball, so it kind of arcs around in like a banana, whereas the strawberry comes the other way. But you know, why strawberry? I think one of the players was playing around and one of the top players kind of said, let's call it the strawberry because it goes the other way. I'm coming inside the ball, according to Adam Bobro.
Our esteemed commentary.
Yeah, absolutely. Closing in, setting sail, you sense now. Mini Sue here. Clad in pink, which is normally quite softening and welcoming as a colour, but at the moment she should be wearing red like a raging bull. She's been vicious throughout, hasn't she? Like a deadly assassin the other side of the net. Just that little bit too sharp, too often.
Yeah, and she's able now, as it's gone on, make the point about Dadeen, when she's pushed half a foot into away from the table, she's not quite as effective. That's what she was able to do here. You see Dadeen just gradually shuffling back.
Two massive points away now. Six match points and team match points as well for Mini Sue here.